Deonarine Singh, who came to St. Lucia from Guyana in the 1980s, still had the side of his face stained by dry blood when we visited his home. Mr. Singh, who is commonly known as the Peanut Man, recalled at some time after 5:30 on Friday morning, he was loading his van with nuts to deliver along the coast when he heard his cats crying and went to a bottom floor room to get food for them.
As I was coming out the room, these four young men with cloth around here and caps on their head, they just rush at me and I fell to the floor on my back, right? And then one of them started screaming, "Help, help!" And then there was this one with duct tape, and he started duct taping my mouth. And he said, "If you continue screaming," and one had a cutlass in his hand, one had a knife, one had a chopper, a chef chopper. And the guy with the knife put his knife here and said, if you continue screaming, I'm going to punch you in your heart."
Mr. Singh says he tried to reason with the masked men, all of whom were armed with sharp instruments, including a machete. He recalled that one of the men hit him on the head with the butt end of a long knife and bound and gagged him with duct tape and telephone wires that were in the house. The businessman says prior to that, one of the men had demanded keys to other parts of the house, including the upper floor, where his wife was sleeping, unaware of what was taking place downstairs.
"I said, the keys on the door, take it, right? And they go and take the bunch. Which one? Which?" I said, "The bigger one of the bigger set." So they said, "Okay," but they were tumbling up all over. They brought the TV and put it here to make the getaway with one of these two vehicles. Well, they had my keys for the Jeep. And they were tumbling, and the next thing I knew, when I run in the kitchen, I lock the door, I run outside, and I jump the fence at the back there. And I run at the back, and I jump the neighbor fence and start screaming for him, "Leon, Leon."
Leon came to Mr. Singh's aid, but by that time, the bandits had fled with some mobile telephones and other items.
"The youths nowadays, they don't want to work. All what they want to do is try to stick up you, hold up you, and fight you down for what you have, when they themselves can be in the hot sun to feel what it is to work for what you need. You understand what I mean? As a ghetto youth, I love ghetto youth, but ghetto youth do certain things that they call for, they don't deserve. And instead of protecting, they go violating and abusing."
Mr. Mathre believes that all business people should be given firearms to protect themselves and their property from bandits. Deonarine Singh says when he came to St. Lucia, he lived in a small apartment that he rented for $50 a month. But he says he had a dream of becoming a successful businessman and started with one bag of peanuts, which he retailed. He graduated to becoming an importer of various types of nuts and achieved his dream. His simple advice to those who seek to rob others of what they have worked hard to achieve is this: put yourself in the other person's shoes and work hard for whatever you want in life. For the DBS News World, I am Jason Hullingseed.